Be intense, but be polite.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Before I move on to my argument, I would like to make some rebuttal. First off, I don't know what the fish is. So first off, they even believe that their citizens are dumb. So they may think that they themselves is also dumb because they are a citizen of their country. So because they meant that their citizens are dumb and stupid, so that's why they say with a more technical word, manipulate them, which on our side is mean propaganda them. They try to mind wash their own citizens. So about the harm, we accept that this is senseless killing and that war shouldn't happen, or even if it happened, we should win the war. We accept the harms. But our stand is, we believe that the status quo right now is already solving it, which I will tell you in my argument. Now, to my second rebuttal. The government allowed the full coverage of said area, which I already POI before. So how can it be safe for the media to go in when that a lot of their soldiers died and a lot of their life is wasted in that? Now to my third rebuttal. The PM mentioned about the illusion and the transparency of that citizen will feel when heard of this illusion of war. So it's just like they're trying to blind their own citizen with false information that they have placed it for it to happen. Now, we say that, as you know, there are many wars that happen, but status quo right now is already solving them. Why? Let's look at our medias right now. Nowadays, movies, podcasts, radios, and even TV series are already showing the horror of war, which I will mention further in my argument. As the government clearly mentioned, the media have a lot of influence on the citizens. So that is why the status quo is already work. Now, our team stand is we will remain status quo, which is already work. Now, let me make team split. I as the RO will speak. My first argument is about there's no place where horror war can fit in. Second argument is about how status quo already solves this thing. And my third argument is about how the government try to propagate their own citizens. Now, my second speaker will speak about the preserve of human dignity from remains status quo because the government is trying to destroy it. And now, the second argument is about the abundance of media becoming a terrorist to demoralize the government. Now, to my first argument. There's no place where horror war can fit in. Why? Free TV, free radio is for everyone, for everybody, for every people, from a younger to an elder. Do you think that when you show a picture of a soldier shooting any other country's soldier, will make an 8-year-old child proud of it, know of it, what happened? Maybe he might just think like a GTA case. He might go and kill a taxi. Because he said this is using a gun. I don't know. Oh, this is gun. It's nicely used. Oh, I want to use it too. I'm 8 years old grabbing my father's gun and shoot a taxi. This is even causing more trouble than solving it. Now, this also doesn't solve anything because war have two sides. For example, the Vietnam War. How are you going to show on that one, the Vietnam War, if the case like that happened? When the US lost, but Vietnam people lost even more, but they won. So, do the government want to show to make more of their soldiers come to Vietnam and want it and win it, try to win it at last? That's not gonna stop anything. Only more and more people will die instead of trying to stop the war. Now, to my second argument, many medias right now already show a horror of war, as I mentioned in my introduction. For example, the movies, look at many nice element movies have been coming out. The World Trade Center one, the 25 hours one. It's already showed the horror of war and what happens. And people are afraid of it right now. Yes.
Between Tom Hanks being killed on screen and your father being shot in the battlefield, which one affects you more?
Ladies and gentlemen, this movie is based on real story. They use the real name, and the ceremony at the end of the story also used the real name of a person who lost their life in the event. So, this, even Tom Hanks get killed, but he does not name Tom Hanks in the movie. It still represents the person that got killed in that event. So this clearly give a warning to citizen and give a horror of it. So the government case doesn't solve anything. Now the series, TV show, just like CSI, are always having every on the 9/11. They always have special episode to present the horror of what happened. And the books, even your English class are forcing you to read a book about the horror of war as your assignment. So now let me give you a clear example of how the government failed. Look at the World War II. During the World War II, if we let the media go into the concentration camps where they get Jews and try to use them just like as a slave in there. If you let the media show the full horror, there is even rape in that. Do you want the media to show the rape scene to make you know? This is that, and that's when you get rape or anything rape. There's a full horror. And rape is also a horror of war when you get raped in a concentration camp. They are so fail. Now to my third argument. They are trying to make another propaganda for their own citizens, for their selfishness. How? Because the government control the place where they can step the media to go in. As they mentioned, to answer to my PI, for the safety of the media, yeah. The media is testing everywhere, but it's your, even the place where it's your troop lying dead from the government side. So why would you send a place then if your media is sent everywhere, even where your troop die? The reason we can think that is because the government wants to blindside their own citizens, to make them believe what the government wants them to, as they mentioned. But and to my watch, that people to give what the government is supposed to. Is that work? Is that gonna work? Because at the end of the day, the truth is still lying behind. The government is selfish, and the media is trying to show the truth anyway. Just like the CNN encrypted crypt on WikiLeaks. So now let me summarize what I mentioned to you so far. So first of all, I mentioned about there's no place where this horror war can fit in, and many medias right now, which is my stance for, it's already worked solving the harms that the government mentioned, and the government is trying to fool their own citizens. So that's why I'm proud to oppose. Thank you.
Further the case of the government.